So when you draw the top view for the first stage, you have two options. You can draw the top view like this, where the two edges, they are perpendicular to the XY line, or you can draw the top view in this way, okay, where the two edges, they are equally inclined by 45 degree. So the correct position is the second position, because after rotation, it should rest on one of its corner, that is a base corner, okay. So draw the top view in this way, and then take the projections, and then you can complete the front view. So this is your first stage. In the second stage, just rotate this first stage front view in the clockwise direction, such that axis will be inclined by 30 degree, and then complete the front view as it is. So dimensions, that is the size of second stage front view and first stage front view, both are same. Then take the projections and complete the top view. Okay. So your sequence will be, this is the first, second, third, and the fourth. So you can observe the position in a software. So this is the position in the first stage and in the second stage. So in the first stage, these edges of the base, they are equally inclined at 45 degree. So you can observe the first stage front view. So it is a triangle, and the top view, it is a square having the diagonals, and these edges, they are at 45 degree. Okay. For the second stage, you will just rotate this front view. So observe here how to rotate that. So this is the similar condition as the first stage. Okay. Now just rotate this in the clockwise direction, so that the axis inclination with the horizontal plane, it will be 30 degree, and its corner, it must be on the HP. Okay. So here you can observe, this is the base corner. Okay. So it is resting on base corner on the HP, axis is inclined at 30 degree, okay. And at the same time, that axis is parallel to the vertical plane. So now if you observe from the front direction, you can observe here, first stage front view and the second stage front view, both are same. Only difference is in the top view. So this is the top view in the second stage, okay. Now here, there are three hidden edges. So you can observe the hidden edges. So you can observe here. This is the first hidden edge. So basically, this is a base edge. This is also base edge. Okay. And here you can observe from this point to this point, this is the hidden lateral edge. Okay, that is called as a slant edge. So there are total three edges which are hidden, and on this hidden edge, that is a slant edge, there is a visible line. So in a three dimension, you can observe. So this is the visible edge, which is a slant edge. Okay, and this slant edge, it is the hidden edge, because it is away from the observer in the top. Okay. Okay, so now let us see how to draw on a drawing paper. So we will start from the first stage top view. Okay, so draw one horizontal line which is parallel to the XY line. So this is just a reference line. Then draw the base edge incline at 45 degree and then complete the square. So this angle is 45 degree. So these four sides, they are the base edges of that square. Okay, because it is a square prism. Then show the diagonals. So if you observe the top view of the prism and top view of the pyramid, okay, so what is the difference? For the pyramid, if you observe from the top direction, then the lateral edges will be observed, okay, and these lateral edges are represented as the diagonals, okay. So basically these lateral edges, they are the slant edges of that pyramid. Then take the projections in the front view. So here in the problem, the height of that pyramid is given. So draw one vertical line. So this is the axis line, and on this axis line you can mark the height. Okay, so you have to draw the line. So basically this line, it will represent the height. At the same time, it will represent this lateral slant edge. Okay, now join the points. So this is the base and these are the slant edges. Okay, so you can give the names ABCD and the center point, that is called as the apex. So take this point as O. So this is the O dash. So this base, this is A dash, then this is B dash, this is C dash, and this will be D dash. Okay, now to complete the second stage front view, you can draw the line at 60 degree. So that will represent the base, and then you can draw the line. So this will represent the axis. So this axis, it is inclined at 30 degree. Okay, and then you can complete the front view similar to the first stage. Now take the projections from the first stage top view and the second stage front view. So before that, give the names. So this is A dash, this is B dash and D dash, and this is C dash, and this apex is the O dash. Okay, now take the projections and then find out the intersections. So here you can observe this point. So here the projections is from A dash point. So this will be point A. This point will be, so this is the projection from the B dash and D dash. Okay, so this will be B point. Sorry, this is a D point if you observe from the top view. Okay, and this point, it will be point B, and this is the point C. So this is a C dash point. Okay, now try to observe from the front view. Sorry, top view. Okay, so O dash A dash, it is nearer to the observer. So here the edge is AB, base edge, and AD, two edges will be visible. So it is shown here by continuous thick line. So this is AD and this is AB. Then these are the slant edges. So basically they are extreme edges in the top view. So must be visible. So this is point O, because this is the O dash point, that is the apex. So OD slant edge, it is visible. OB is also visible. Okay, now the edges which are inside the extreme edges, they must be hidden. Okay, So you can observe here, there are three hidden edges, which is DC, BC, and the OC. So we will show this by dash line. So this is the first hidden edge, that is DC. Second is BC, and next one is a OC. Okay. Now there is one visible edge which will overlap on the hidden edge. So that visible edge, which is nearer to the observer. So this is the edge which is O dash, A dash. Okay. So connect this edge OA, that is a slant edge, by continuous thick line. So hidden line will not be visible. So this hidden line, it will be just below that visible line. So we have to just draw the continuous thick line. Okay. So this is how you can complete the top view.